This is the weather forecast video for Friday, November the 18th, 2011. Let's first take a look at the college football forecast, where number 2 Oklahoma State is going to be visiting Iowa State at Jack Trice Stadium in Ames this evening, where it'll be fairly nice for the game, just some winds from the south and temperatures in the mid-40s at game time. Here's the satellite image from last evening, seeing some high to mid-level cloudiness streaming into the state from the plains and the Northern Rockies in the Pacific Northwest, where some heavy snow will be possible over that area through the weekend. Here's the watch warning map from just before midnight. Winter storm watches, winter storm warnings, winter weather advisories from the Dakotas through the Pacific Northwest, including the Rockies, the Cascades, and the Sierra Nevada range. Otherwise, the rest of the nation is fairly quiet. QPF chart. Precipitation over the next 5 days, this is through Tuesday evening at 6 o'clock, shows the heaviest amounts of rain from Oklahoma and Texas, east northeastward into the Tennessee and Ohio Valley. Here we could see anywhere up to a tenth, maybe a quarter of an inch of rain with rain on Saturday. Let's take a look at the 0Z GFS model run at 6 p.m. this evening. You can see there's the storm system with the Vortmax over the Pacific Northwest moving into the Northern Rockies. With that, low pressure will be developing in the northern parts of Colorado. Rain in the valleys, snow in the mountains in the Pacific Northwest, the Rockies, and streaming into the plain states, where here we'll just have southerly winds, which will continue into Saturday before a cold front comes through. By Saturday evening, low pressure will be in the northeastern part of the state, with rain to the south and east, snow to the north and west. Sunday, that's gone. High pressure moves in. It'll be cooler, highs in the upper 30s to mid-40s, with the chances of rain in the Ohio and Tennessee Valley. By Monday, it still is the case. The rain is south of the state, maybe a few high clouds. Otherwise, temperatures will be in the 40s, with high pressure nearly directly overhead. Tuesday, same story. Could be a few clouds over far southeast Iowa with the storm system in the Ohio and Tennessee and lower Mississippi Valley. Otherwise, it'll be mostly sunny in the 40s. Wednesday, the big travel day. Looks fairly quiet across the country, only a few problems along the east coast and in the south and maybe along the Pacific Northwest. Otherwise here, winds will be beginning to turn to the south by Thanksgiving Day, which will be fairly warm with highs in the lower to middle 50s, maybe some upper 50s possible, with fairly gusty winds out of the south at about 10 to 20. And a week from today, Black Friday, the big shopping day. Looks like a broad trough moving into the plain states at that time with some vorticity maxes, and with that there could be a few showers developing with the return flow from the Gulf and continued south to southwesterly winds and warm temperatures likely in the upper 40s to mid 50s. We head further into Voodoo. Here's November the 28th, another trough and axis moving through the plains and into the upper Midwest, with a wavy pattern across the country, and frontal system moving in with a low pressure near Thunder Bay, Ontario, with a trailing cold front that looks like could bring wet conditions, not white at least at this time. And we head to the end of the forecast on December the 3rd. Here's a fairly decent trough axis extending from western Ontario down the Mississippi River Valley into Texas, with a Vortmax down there. And with that could bring some substantial cold weather to the state and some substantial snow even as far south as Missouri and Arkansas, but we'll wait and see if that occurs. Thank you for tuning in to the weather forecast video. We'll have another one tomorrow.